Tonight is a bit of an experiment of sorts. We are going to we're going to give you little snapshot views into the things that you're going to be seeing from week to week, from day to day, perhaps. That all depends on how many of you show up.
Engineers at the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear plant are facing yet another challenge in the troubled work to decommission the facility. They installed a steel barrier in an effort to prevent contaminated groundwater from reaching the sea. But now they say it led to an increase in the amount of contaminated water. In October, Tokyo Electric Power Company, or TEPCO, had the steel piling wall built along the plant's embankment. The initial plan was to pump up groundwater, remove radioactive materials, and then release most of the water into the sea. On Friday, TEPCO officials told nuclear regulators that some of the groundwater is too salty to be processed by the decontamination equipment at the facility. They also said they discovered the need to pump up more water than initially planned. The officials say because the water cannot be released into the sea, workers are putting it into reactor buildings at a rate of about 400,000 liters per day. The utility has been making efforts to reduce the flow of water into buildings where it gets contaminated. Those efforts include pumping up groundwater from wells inside the compound, which did manage to reduce the amount going into buildings. However, the effect of such efforts has been canceled out by the decision to divert untreated water from the embankment into the buildings.
What's so funny now?
I sometimes just think funny things.
TEPCO says it plans to pump up more groundwater upstream so that less reaches the embankment. It says it will also try to process a greater amount of salty water by carefully monitoring its quality.
Japan's government has been deciding how best to clean up. That's to clean up Fukushima following the 2011 nuclear disaster. Sources tell NHK the government won't be decontaminating much of the region's forests. They say the work may have adverse effects on communities. So far, the cleanup work has been limited to forests within 20 meters of communities. Until now, the fate of those further away hasn't been clear. A panel of experts has been studying the matter. Sources say the government hasn't found dangerous radioactive materials dispersing from forests, but officials did find another area of concern. The removal of fallen leaves will expose topsoil that could be washed away. They plan to set up wooden fences on steep hills to prevent erosion and thin trees to try to make the forest healthier.
My monologue looks something like this. This has not been seen yet. I'm unveiling this for the first time on live computer vision. There it is. Can we see it? Do we see it? Can we see it?
What is it?
What do you think it is?
A tattoo?
Yes,
it's
it is. Winning. Yes, winning.
Winno!
Winning.
What?
Because guess what we're doing? Guess what we're doing all day,
winning.
Every second,
winning.
Workers are removing signboards praising nuclear power from one of two towns where the crippled Fukushima Daiichi nuclear plant is located.
Winning.
I've been talking
about everyone out there who thinks that they've been winning along with us, who's been supporting this entire movement. That is, in fact, winning. I want you to go to your window. I want you to open it, because if you don't, then no one can hear you. And I want you to join our chant, winning.
Winning!
The placards were put up in Futaba about 25 years ago. The two signboards bear slogans touting the potential of nuclear power. But the whole town has been within a designated evacuation area since the 2011 nuclear accident at the plant. Town officials were concerned that the deteriorating boards could hurt people paying a short visit to their home.
By the time you pull it out, it can't be traced to where it comes from, the prostitution or the drugs or whatever it is that you got. They got caught doing that, and they promised, I got to say this slowly, otherwise I'll just break up and laugh in front of you, and that wouldn't look right. I'm a professor, after all. They promised not to do this again. Yes, exactly, right.
One of the slogans was written by Yuji Onuma in his childhood. It was selected in a contest. He's been calling for the preservation of the sign.
The town is deserted, and this sign has been left behind with a hollow message. I find it ironic. I thought long and hard about the best course of action and decided that this sign should be preserved to convey the negative image it connotes.
Town officials plan to keep the signs in storage and eventually arrange for them to be put on display as a symbol of unintended consequences.
Somebody educate him. So that brings us to another portion of our show that will resist, I think, I'm sorry.
See the cats.
I can see nothing.
Power company officials will take another step towards scrapping a nuclear facility in western Japan. They'll submit plans on Tuesday to close the aging number one reactor at Saga Prefecture's Genkai plant.
The cats were unbelievable. Cats winning against dogs. Yes, of course.
Should we show that, Charlie?
I've never seen that.
These aren't winning images. I don't know what it is.
The reactor went into operation in 1975. Plant operator Kyushu Electric decided in April to decommission the facility. The move came following a regulation limiting the lifespan of reactors to 40 years in principle. Officials will submit the plan to the Nuclear Regulation Authority. They say it will require 28 years to complete the decommissioning. Plant operators in Japan have already decided to scrap five reactors over 40 years old, including the one at the Genkai facility. Kyushu Electric will be the first to submit such a decommissioning plan.
Any cat sounds?
What was it?
I think you do a car crash.
Good.
Or a fart.
Promise we'll have more sound of it soon, right?
Yeah, oh yeah, no, yes. Next up it's going to be a very much...
Okay, good.
I'm going to be winning next time with this.
Good, good, good. Excellent. And then, of course, where a lot of shows would take you to the bad news, we're not going to just go to the good news. We're going to go to the winning news. What other kind of news is there? Loot, duh.
A new earthquake study by the Japanese government has important safety information for anyone living in a high-rise. It found that swaying in high-rise buildings can be affected by the length of vibrations in an earthquake.
He was the youngest Eagle Scout in his troop's 65-year history. Clearly, a winner.
Winning!
Yes.
The study released on Thursday already has people talking. NHK World's Tomoko Kurabayashi has the details.
So scary. There's no way to escape.
People in Osaka reacting to a video. A simulation of what happens inside a high-rise during an earthquake. Furniture tossed around, intense swaying. A new study from the Japanese government says the swaying can be a lot worse. It all depends on where the earthquake hits. The study looked at the Nankai Trough of the Pacific Coast from Tokai to Kyushu in western Japan. It found swaying in buildings will be much worse if a quake struck this area. And experts say the Nankai Trough is overdue for a big jolt. If a big earthquake hit this area, it could produce what scientists call long-period ground motion. That means ground movement during an earthquake that causes vibrations that last a long time. Earthquakes causing short, quick ground vibrations do not generate intense swaying, but long-period ground motion causes intense swaying in high-rise buildings. And inside, there's lots of damage. The March 2011 powerful quake that hit northern Japan did this in Tokyo. This is a video from a restaurant in a high-rise. Skyscraper in Tokyo swayed slowly. The mega quake generated long period ground motion. The swaying does not die down, even in areas far from the epicenter. And it's a huge concern for this disaster relief expert.
There can be more than 1,000 people in each skyscraper. Several million people could be affected by the swaying. If they're hit by heavy objects, it could kill them. Precautions must be taken.
Winning. Way to go, Zachary. We all here salute you and welcome you aboard the winning team.
And some cities are already taking those precautions. So, Japan's tourist building in Osaka was built equipped with the latest technology. It limits swaying during an earthquake. The walls over the middle floors have steel plates. They are designed to absorb energy from tremors and minimize the effects. News of the study has already reached people in the business of selling homes in high-rises.
We will take the results into consideration. We would like to think about them for the work we do.
The March 2011 earthquake had a magnitude of 9.0. Experts say another mega earthquake could hit at any time. But with continued study and action being taken, the country can be as prepared as possible for the inevitable. Tomoko Kurabayas, NHK World.
Yeah, now this is a story that I kind of questioned, although there is an absolute win involved in this story. But tell me, am I reading this wrong?
Residents of a disaster-hit town in northeastern Japan are celebrating the return of something many take for granted, the return of routine life. They lost loved ones, homes, even medical services in the 2011 earthquake and tsunami. Well, 4.5 years on, they are hailing the reopening of their local hospital.
Regardless of all of his street cred that he has now, I just don't see that that supports his winning ways.
The new Minami Sanriku Hospital is built on higher ground than its predecessor. The modern three-story building consists of 10 departments, with 90 beds for inpatients, as well as a nursing care facility.
It's very convenient to have a hospital in town and a doctor who can see me immediately when I'm not well.
Sharif Haircut Burger. He said I'm in a state of denial. And so, yeah, you're right, dude. I'm in such a state of denial that I deny that you exist. You're gone. You're gone.
A tsunami more than 15 meters high flooded the old hospital up to the fourth floor. 74 patients and staff were killed. And it also left the area with no medical services. In the medical aid station set up immediately after the disaster, Dr. Masafumi Nishizawa organized support teams from around the country and worked hard to provide care to all local residents.
I've heard the water supply is running low. Still, we'll continue to take care examining patients, mainly to prevent the spread of disease.
In some cases, he had to send doctors to remote areas. Despite support from home and abroad, the hospital could not be rebuilt right away. Some patients had to check into a facility in a neighboring city 35 kilometers away.
Traveling so far to look after the patients has been really tough on both our staff and the patients' families.
Japan's self-defense forces helped with the task of transporting 22 patients from the distant facility to the new hospital. It took an hour for each trip between the two locations. At the new building, Nishizawa was ready for their arrival. The patients need to be transported with extreme care. And 4 hours after the start of the operation, everyone had been safely transferred.
I'm really grateful for your help in completing the transfers so smoothly. Thank you very much. Now the hospital has been rebuilt, I feel we are finally back at the start line. The physical side is ready, so next we hope to provide the soft side, good medical services the community can trust.
But there are still obstacles to overcome, as there are only 3 full-time doctors at the hospital. It really needs another 4, so it has been relying temporarily on part-time doctors from several universities. We asked an expert who has been working in the worst affected areas.
We need to build a permanent system for stationing doctors in these areas. Under a new government policy, medical schools in Japan can now accept more students. So one solution would be to encourage schools to increase the number of doctors.
If the disaster hit region is to get properly back on its feet, healthcare services are indispensable to a full recovery. That's why a thorough and robust medical system needs to be put in place as soon as possible.
Anyway, never speak of you. And here's where we go to the softer side of this whole little segment here. We kind of wish I were them for 10 minutes, which is a lot for a mad genius warlock like myself.
Finally evening comes, so me sit down round a back and read a book and will a jive. Soon you know me not have to take no chat from the boy, cause me don't have a plan for them. And it no mean me I go say no man for them. Cause if a book them a read and a treat we like clown, who say we have to take it lying down? Knowledge is the power, we control the tower, and rival Elizabeth crown. Yeah, things will be better, up, up, me sister, my elevator. Rise with the wind like a flame. I never give in, no. And I will always grow as long as I'm living. Yeah, I'm living. Oh yeah. Now if Papa Marty is not away, we slap him with a book. You see gloom and dismay. We slap him with a book. All evil same way. We slap him with a book. Determination on display. Things will be better. Up, up, me say step or elevator. Rise with the wind like a feather. Fly with the eagle, then we sing like a bird. You set me like better. Up, up, me say step or elevator. No matter what the time or the weather. Fly with the eagle, then we sing, we sing. Said it's been a long, long, long day in the sun. angles. What you going to make them come hunt me down when the troops them deploy? Disrespect, all I call man boy. I rather sing one song for them than make my family come sing no song kidding. Because I know them sink and I pass along down. That's when you got to take it lying down. But knowledge is the power, you control the tower. So don't make them catch you spell down, cause things will be better. Up, up, me sister, for really better. Rise with the wind like a feather. Fly with the eagle, then we sing like a bird. Things have to get better. Up, up, me sister, for really better. No matter what the time or the weather. Fly with the eagle, then we sing like a bird. Should know is that I never give in, oh, I never give in, oh, oh. And if I poverty not the way, we slap him with a book, you see gloom and dismay. We slap him with a book, all evil same way. We slap him with a book, determination on display, yeah.